Assalamualaikum, we continue with the second video for chapter 3. Yeah, so we continue a little bit the objective, the remaining objective. Okay, so in this video, we're going to look into the decision-making process. Okay, so as a manager, they want to make the decision. There are 7 steps that they have to follow. Yeah, the first one is identifying opportunities and diagnosing problems. The number 2 is identifying objective. Step number 3 is generating alternatives. Step number 4 is evaluating alternative. Number 5 is reaching decisions. Number 6 is choosing implementation strategies. And the last step is monitoring and evaluating feedback. Okay, step number 1, identifying opportunities and diagnosing problems. Okay, so the manager need to not only solve the problems, okay, and also they also need to identify opportunities or the benefits or chances or opportunity that they can take for the success of the organization. Okay, so first they need to identify what they can take. Okay, and also when they face with the problems, okay, so the first thing that they have to do is they must diagnose the problem. Diagnose means that they must come up with the clear, very clear about the problems, okay, the opportunities and so on. The second step is identifying objective. Okay? Objectives reflect the results of the organization wants to attain, also called targets, standards or ends. Okay? So before the manager or the leader want to solve the situation, the problems or take the opportunity, they must know what are the objectives of the organization. This is important so that they will, whatever that the decision that they make or they take or whatever they decided, it is according to the objective for the best of the organization. Okay, the third step is generating alternative. Okay, so the manager, okay, develop various ways to solve the problems and achieve objective. Okay, so now after they're very clear about the problems, okay, and they know what they want to achieve, what objective that they have to fulfill. So now it's time for them to list out all the choices, the options that they have, okay, the alternative that they have in order to solve the problems. Okay. Okay. After they're done listing all the choices, the alternative that they have to solve the problems, now they need to evaluate, okay, each of the problem. They have to see one by one what are the benefits, okay, advantages, disadvantages for each of the alternative. There are certain criteria that they can look into each alternative. Okay, for example, they can see in terms of the quality, okay, desired that they want from the options, okay, the cost, the benefits, the uncertainties and the risk for each of the choices or the alternative that they have. The fifth step is for them reaching the decisions. Okay, after they have seen, okay, they have evaluated all of the alternative, they will choose which one of the best. Okay, which of the alternative is the best for them to implement. Okay? So after they choose, okay, so they will choose implementation strategies. So this is now the stage, okay, for them to implement. Okay, if we choose to do option number 1, so what are the things that or the activities that we need to do in order for us to solve the problems or to fulfill our objective? And the last one is monitoring and evaluating. Okay, the decision making process is complete until not complete and until the impact of the decision has been evaluated, meaning that for all the decision, the activities that we've done, okay, we have to make sure that we always monitor and we evaluate whether the decisions that we've made, the actions that we have taken, is very successful and able to solve the problems according to the objective that we have set. Okay, so this is the last step. Okay, so under the decision making, okay, mostly the manager, of course, they will have to do the decision on their own. Okay, but sometimes manager can also invite people or do the decision in group. Okay, so we have three types. Okay, of group decision making. Group decision making in that the manager will make the decisions in a group. Okay, so that's what we call as group decision making in a group, not the manager himself that have to do the decision. Okay, so here we have three major types of group decision making. The first one is brainstorming. Okay, brainstorming is very familiar, very famous. You always do brainstorming. Okay, a technique used to enhance creativity, okay, that encourages group members to generate as many novel ideas as possible. Okay, so when we do the brainstorming, all the individuals or the group members, okay, we come up with the ideas. Okay, so the objective of brainstorming is to collect as many ideas as we can. So usually when we think with a group of people, the idea will get better, will be more creative. Okay, the second group decision making that we can use, okay, is nominal group technique, or we call as NGT. Okay? Individual members list their ideas on the specific problem and present the ideas at one time without discussion. Okay? Members' ideas are recorded so that everyone can see them. After all members' ideas are presented, the group discuss the ideas to clarify and evaluate them. So compared to the brainstorming, we just voice out all our ideas and then we discuss, we list everything, and then after that we discuss in a group. Okay, for the NGT, nominal group technique, all the members, okay, release their ideas, okay, on their own. Okay, after they have finished listing all the ideas, and then they will present it to the group. Okay, and then after that they will discuss it. Okay, and the last one is Delphi technique, an approach that uses the experts to make predictions and forecasts about future events without meeting face to face. Okay, Delphi technique is when the manager or the organization, okay, will find the expert in those areas. Okay, so they present or they inform the expert, okay, expert for the area, about the problems that they have. So what are their objectives, what are their concerns. Okay, so the expert will discuss it among other experts, where the discussion won't be face to face. Okay, so each of the expert will list out all the ideas and then send it back to the organization. Okay, so meaning that each of the experts, okay, maybe we have one expert company A, one expert company B, and so on. So we propose the problems to each of the expert. So each of the expert come up with their own solution or ideas and then submit it to our company, and then the company will decide which is the best. Okay, so this is done without meeting face to face. Okay, so of course there are advantages and disadvantages when we do the group decision making. Okay, so you can see among the advantages for group decision making, of course we can get more information, more ideas. Okay, better decisions. Okay, however, there are disadvantages. For example, of course, it will take longer time. Okay, compromise. One person may dominate the group, and groupthink may occur. Groupthink is when, for example, inside the group, okay, when you want to make decision, and everyone have agreed to choose option A. Well, for you, you alone, you prefer option B. But since everyone is in favor of A, so you kind of, okay lah, then we choose A. Okay? So that's what I mean by groupthink. Okay? So that's it for chapter 3. I hope you understand chapter 3. And I will see you in chapter 4.